here it is, it's drawn like this, and this portion and this edge would inside coincide with this edge, so it will not be visible over here. This inner cut will not be visible, hence it is drawn by dotted line like this. So this is glass box theory, which is employed to give an object. Now, things to note over here. The projection planes like this. Project, first of all, decide the plane of projection. The projectors, which are the projectors? These are the projectors or projection lines. How surface A and B are projected? Think about this. Surface is A and B. Surface A is parallel to this plane. Hence, its shape would remain as it is. But the surface B is a taper surface. Hence, in a top view, its total length will reduce like this. This is the total length of surface B. It will reduce to this length in top view. Similarly, in front view and side view, it will reduce. The blocks is unfolded, creating the six principal views like this. This is the box. It is unfolded, and after unfolding, it will appear like this. So these are the views, six views: front view, two side view, top view, bottom view, and rear view or back view. Now, principal views. What's principal view? This is an object. Here, steps to draw all principal views. Object is lying inside the box. First, this is front view as we have drawn. Name each views. So this is the view. What should be named? This is front view. We are looking from front side, so it appears like this. This is a rectangle. It would appear like this. This is top view, as color is shown by red colored. In top view, it would appear like this. This is the right hand side view. We are looking from right side. Right hand side view is drawn to the right side of front view. So which method is employed over here? Yes, here right hand side view is drawn to the right side of the object. So this is third angle projection method. You can draw by any of the method, it doesn't matter, because the ultimate aim would be fulfilled whichever method is to be used to draw any object. This is right side view. This is rear view. You can see the difference between front view and rear view over here. In front view, these lines are full line, you can see here, and in a rear view, this is dotted line, this is dotted line, and this is also dotted line. And this is left hand side view. If we look this object from left side, our left side, the object would appear like this, an L shape object, and here dotted lines is to be drawn to show these invisible edges. One is this edge is not visible in left hand side view, as well as this edge would not appear, this tapered edge would not appear if you are looking from this side. So that is to be shown by dotted line over here. So these are the six views of given object and representation of multi views of given object. It's a very simple object, and the object is not symmetrical about any axis, so its all views are different. You can see here some difference is there in all views. The shapes will be same, just the difference is the types of line. In some view, the dotted line will be there, and in some views, full lines would be there. But you can notice over here that in all views, the outside shape is always alike. Always it's similar. Suppose this is outside line, full line, L shape. So here also outside line is a full line and it's of L shape. And always outside lines are never dotted line. So its outside view will be similar in all the cases, whether the object is symmetrical or it is asymmetrical. This is bottom view. What are the differences between the right side view and left hand side view that we had discussed? This is the line. There are mirror images with one different line type, here full line and here dotted line. What are the differences between the top view and bottom view and front view and rear view that you can notice over here? They are mirror images with different line types. Similarly, what views have the least amount of hidden or dashed lines? You can see or you can discuss that in front view and top view, least amount of dashed line or dotted lines are there. Hence, it is always advisable to select the views in which least amount of dotted lines are there. So here, to draw this object, we should select front view, top view, and either of these two views, say right hand side view, because in these three views, top view, front view, and right hand side view, least number of dashed lines are there. So as the number of dotted lines are less, these three views to be drawn, and it would be easier for the learner or for the person to imagine the shape of this object. Front views and top views are there. Now this is an exercise. Fill the following dotted orthographic projections with the appropriate line type. Think about this object and how to draw views of this object. We can use any of the concept which we discussed earlier, either glass box theory or the operator or the person moving around its three faces, front view, top view and side view, or the object to be moved towards the learner, towards the viewer. This is an object. This is another method. Think about this object and color the shape which would be visible in top view. So you can see here, if we are looking from top side, this portion would be visible as colored by yellow shape. Yellow colored would be visible in top view like this. So this would be its top view. Can see here, this face would not be visible in top view, so they are not shown over here. Here circle is there, circular hole is there, it is to be drawn over here as per the given dimension. This shape would be full line, it would be visible in top view, so it is drawn by full line. Here you can imagine, in case of bottom view, this line, this and this, this line will not be visible. Hence, in case of bottom view, this line and this line will be drawn as a dotted line. And the circular hole is made throughout these two faces, so it will be visible in both the views, in top view as well as in bottom view. Now think about another view, front view. If we look from the front side, this face, which is colored by blue, would be visible. This face, blue colored portion, it would be visible in front view. So draw this shape, blue colored shape, and this green colored portion will also be visible in front view like this. If you are looking from front side, this taper shape would appear, but its total length would reduce by some amount, because this face is not parallel to the plane of vision. Hence, it will not be appear as a true shape, but it's an inclined shape. Now think about the right hand side view. If you look from the right hand side view of this object, this red colored portion will appear like this. This is the cut triangle which is shown over here like this. So this portion is visible as shown by red color like this. This red triangle, reversed red triangle, is visible over here like this. So this is right hand side view of given object. Now fill in the hidden lines into front, top and right side views like this. If you look from the top side, this inner edge like this, this portion, this edge and this edge will not be visible. Hence, the edges which are not visible in top view, it's to be shown by dotted line like this. This edge, this corner, Similarly, if we look from the front side, this circular hole which is drilled in the upper face as well as in the lower face will not be visible. So that is to be indicated by dotted lines like this. So to draw these views, we can project these endpoints of the circle from here to here, from here to here. So that is the dotted line which are shown over here that represents this circular hole. Now if we look from the right hand side view, you can see here this circular hole which is drilled inside this upper face, inside this lower face, will also not be visible. So it should be shown by dotted line like this and dotted line like this. Similarly, this inner edge, this one and this one, which is along this axis, this edge will not be visible in the right hand side view. So we draw these two edges by dotted line like this and like this. So these are the line conventions, how to draw these lines, dotted line and so on. Draw the center lines in all the views. Now third type of line, that is center line. First we drawn full lines, second we drawn dotted line, now third we draw center line. So whenever any radius is there or any arc is there, at that time we have to show center lines of the object. Here circle is there, so always the circle is having center line. So from its axis you can draw center lines like this, which passes through the axis of this circle. Whenever we draw center line of an object, it should be taken care about this point. Here small plus should be there. Some people do here dot or some other indication. It's a wrong practice. Whenever we draw center line of any circle, it should be drawn like this only. A small plus should cross each other and then it should be extended. But in case of smaller diameter hole, if the diameter is too small, in that cases just two full lines should be drawn instead of drawing this center line. Small dashes cross in the middle should be there. This should be noted. Here the notice to be done over here is that the center line connects between features in the same views like this. Here throughout center line should not be drawn. Here instead of drawing center line, full line should be drawn, because here no object is there. Of course here if object is there or circular hole is there, in that case this line should also be drawn as a center line. Now one object is shown over here. Create an object by orthographic projection. Decide how many views are needed for this object, how many and which view is enough to show this object, what can you say about this object. Of course front view would be enough to show its this side, and top view would be enough. For procedural reasons, we will continue this example by drawing all three standard views like this. Draw the visible features of the front view. If we are looking from the front side of this object, this would appear, right? This would be the shape if we look from this direction. These are the projection lines or vertical projections like this, and these are the horizontal projection lines. Front view is to be drawn over here, right hand side view is to be drawn over here, and top view to be drawn over here. And which method is employed over here? Yes, top view is drawn above front view, so this is third angle projection method. Front view is here, take projections from all these views, draw projectors of the front view like this. After drawing this front view, draw the top view like this. So if we are looking at this object from top side, this circle will appear like this. It will be full circle. But this inner cut, which is over here, this corner and this corner will not be visible. Hence, we draw these two corners like this by dotted line, because it is not visible in top view. Now to draw its right hand side view, we move towards the right side, take projections. For that projection, we draw here a line at an angle of 45 degree like this. Take projections from top view like this, project here, and from that draw vertical lines like this. An intersection of these two lines will decide the shape of right hand side view. Here this height of the object is seen in top view, and this height would be width in case of right hand side view, and height in front view and height in side view would be alike, both will be similar. It could be seen over here. So in right hand side view, it would appear just as a rectangle like this, but this circular hole is there, which is there inside this face, and it is not visible in the right hand side view. So it is shown by dotted lines like this. The hole is made to this face only, up to this surface only. So up to this surface we have to draw two dotted lines, and this edge which is inside this face over here below this face passes through this edge, and this edge will not be visible. So we draw these corners or these edges by dotted lines like this. So this is right side view of given object. Here we have drawn center line, full line and dotted line as well. Now project back if needed. If needed, we can draw its back view as well. Draw center lines where necessary. Here circular hole is there, so we draw here center line like this, which passes through the midpoint of the circle like this. Plus is here, small plus should be there, and here this line is to be shown over here. This axis